Hi friends, it's me, Simply Sherry, helping you stop living in chaos, one organizing project at a time. In this video, I'm going to show you how to organize a 72-hour emergency kit for food. First, you want to get a container. I love this box from Staples. I'll put a link in the description box below. It's pretty sturdy, and I like that it's not clear. The other one I was using is a clear one, but I decided to have one that isn't clear. It just makes it look neater from the outside. And I do like bins with this type of handle that clicks into place versus ones that click into place like that. Okay. I've put a label here so that if it's facing out this way on the shelf, you can read it from there. And then I also put a label here in case it's facing out this way on the shelf. I'm gonna open this up. Don't be scared. That's not scary. It looks a little bit intimidating. It looks like a lot, but this is 72 hours worth of food for a family of four. Four meaning we're all pretty much adults. For me, I was thinking of how to organize this best. Should I organize it by category of food? Should I organize it by the meal, whether it's all for lunch, all for dinner, all for breakfast, all for snacks? Or should I categorize it by person? I decided to do it with a mix of that, mainly per person, because within our family, we have different types of allergies and what we prefer to eat. I use a lot of Ziploc bags, gallon size, and also the quart size. And then ones that didn't fit in a gallon size bag, I left it out here, but they are food items that are communal. So you can see I have some chips here. We do have a family member that is allergic to nuts, another family member that chooses to be plant-based. So because of those food needs, I decided to separate the food per person and by the day. So since this is 72 hours, it's day one, day two, and day three. I have a bag here for all of the paper plates, napkins, and utensils like forks, spoons, and knives. And I chose to have them disposable because when, let's say there's an emergency, the power's out, there's no water, you wanna use the least amount of water necessary. So I'm going with disposable. Of course, you can always have like camping plates or camping sporks where there's a fork and knife on one end and a spoon or things like that. And you can definitely use linen napkins, but I thought this would be easier with this type of scenario. The other scenario I thought with this box, the reason I have mainly food in here is because I have a separate thing just for water. This is more for a 72-hour emergency kit, specifically for bugging out. If we need to leave our house, we grab this bin. It will require two people to carry it and put it into the trunk of our car, and then we will get our case of water and our bug out bags. We have a bug out bag each, and we have a bug out bag for our dog. If you want to see that video, I'll link it up above. And we also have her bug out kennel. So here again, communal, they are not in the Ziploc bags. Love Mary's Gone crackers. So for the nut allergies and for the plant-based food, I did go to Whole Foods. It's gonna be a little bit more expensive than other food or maybe in other places, but this is where we found good stuff. And one thing I learned from the other 72-hour emergency kit that I had put together a few years ago was my brother, who's a prepper, he had told me, go through your 72-hour kit, pretend like you're actually using it during a disaster scenario. So my family and I went through it, and one thing I learned was they love the Oreo cookies. But my husband got quickly tired of all the other food. So in this one, I upped it a little bit, I guess, and really thought of something that they would really be okay eating. Imagine you have to bug out and you're going to a school gymnasium and you have to be there for a few days or even a week. They, of course, hopefully will have food, water. They may have cots, they may not. But to have a bin like this where you can't cook indoors, But having food that's specifically for you and you don't have to worry about allergies or whatever, that's the scenario I was thinking of. Because that very specific scenario, but it can play into other scenarios. So here's some plant-based Oreo cookies, although I know Oreo cookies are vegan, okay? And then I just have an extra bag here in a Ziploc with paper towels. Now, the good thing with Ziplocs is because you can put your trash into the Ziploc and keep it here until you have a place to throw it away. We learned that from camping. That's what we usually do in camping if there's no trash bag. Okay, over here you will see some water. Okay, and again, this is just enough water for maybe a day, but we have our other case of water that we would bring with us. We have some milk, okay, and the other one that's communal. Here we have some more. We have some coconut water, okay, and then creamer for hot coffee. So I don't have anything to heat up the hot coffee, but I did put little packs of coffee into the bags only because of the hope that if there's a place that we bug out to, they would have hot water or a place to heat up water. But if not, then we won't be drinking coffee. I do have a lighter just in case, a propane little stove is available. I'd have at least a lighter. And then here I have peanuts, rice crackers, and then some peanut butter. Okay, so my husband, myself, and my son, we can eat peanut butter. So we have a separate one here for each of us. And then there's a third one here. I think I put it in my son's spot. Okay, yeah, I put it in his bag. Okay, so let me show you how I've organized these bags. See, I've taken out all the bags that are for the four of us for 3 days, and you can see that's the majority of what takes up the space in the bin. You can always use the top of the bin as a tabletop or to hold things together. That's why I prefer bins. I've seen other people use rolling luggage, which would be easier to bring along with you. But I like this just so that you have another thing. You could even sit on this. You can use it as a table. So there are four of us. All of us pretty much have the same setup, 3 bags. My son has only 2 bags because all the food fits into 2 bags. So 2 gallon-sized bags and a quart bag. So I just used the label maker and I labeled each bag here with my name in parentheses what these food items are for, breakfast and snack. And of course, it's nice to have the Ziploc bag so that you could see inside. And I also, like I said, you can use them to put trash in and zip it up. Okay, so in here, you can see I have different types of fruit, cups, pineapple, and 2 oranges, dried mangoes. And these are all foods. Again, learning from my previous 72-hour kit, going through it in 3 days, seeing what we liked, what we didn't like, what was hard to prepare. So in here, I decided to put as much as possible food that we don't have to cook, food that we don't have to put water. Okay. We also have here jam, and so that's what the crackers are for, the rice crackers. We also have this salsa, love it, this right size. From the Dollar Tree, and then you saw the tortilla chips. You can go to the Dollar Tree. They have a lot of smaller size items because, again, this is only for 3 days. You don't want to pack a week's worth of food here because it gets heavier, it gets, more things to manage. So I try to make it really concise as far as what we'll be eating each meal. And what I did was to, on a piece of paper, just write out day one, day two, day three, and what each person would be eating for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. And from that menu, I filled up the bags. I have here this ice cream sandwich. Of course, you can always get these types of things in the camping section. This expires, let's see, Best Buy, May 2022. So you can see this can last a while. But the other thing I want you to know is you have to go through this kit every 6 months. The good thing is that September is National Disaster Preparedness Month, and then March is spring cleaning. So automatically built into my calendar is going through this kit, making sure nothing is expired in September and in March. And the things that are about to expire between September and March, we will go ahead and put it into our regular eating menu. Okay, and then here I have some different types of Justin's peanut butter. Okay, again, you can use these on the crackers, you can eat it out of the pouch. Some Clif bars with nuts, without nuts. Okay, so those all go into the breakfast and snacks. In this bag, it's day one, day two, mm-hmm. and then this quart size day three, and then the name. So each person has 3 days and their own bags, okay? So of course, we don't have to only eat day one on day one. You can do day three or you can mix it up. But it just helped me to make sure that every day the meals are complete for my family member. So here in day one, let's see what I have. So you saw the breakfast and the snacks in that other bag. Maybe for lunch, I would have this chicken salad kit that I got from Walmart. And this is great because look, it has the spoon, it has crackers, and it has the tin. So you may think, oh, it's a lot of crackers, 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 crackers. Well, I'm not gonna put bread here because that's gonna go bad. Or I could put bread in Mylar bags or something like that. But I just wanted things that are convenient. I'm showing you things that if you don't know how to can or put Mylar bags or things like that, these are things that you can get at the grocery store. So maybe I would have that for lunch and then maybe with a trail mix. Okay, here's the coffee. Here's some lemonade that I can mix with that water or just in case I want something more than water. Okay, and then this would be for dinner. Okay, so it's basically jerky with some cheese and some pretzels. Have some extra jerky here that I can eat throughout the day. Maybe there for dinner would have the almonds. I have more extra snacks here. And remember, I still have the snacks and the breakfast from the other bag. So lunch, dinner, and extra. Day two is going to be similar, but instead I've put here a ham salad kit and a tuna salad kit for lunch and dinner with the trail mix, the nuts, the Slim Jims. Okay, and then for day three, pretty much the same salad kits, two of them maybe for lunch. And what's different here is that I went ahead and got these single serve Spams. When you're packing the bags, you want to make them as flat as possible. So use anything that's rectangular, put those in, and then you can put them on the sides like that. And then I try to keep the drinks together, the granola and the nuts together. And then these Slim Jims, they just fit right on top like that. And then you close it up. My daughter is allergic to seafood and to nuts. So for her, the protein bars that she has will be these chocolate mint without nuts. Of course, always check the ingredients. And then at Whole Foods, I found these in packets, roasted pumpkin seed butter, roasted watermelon seed butter, and dark chocolate, sunflower seed butter. Again, check the ingredients, make sure that they are okay for the allergies. Earlier, we checked these in September and in March, so you could see that the expiration date here is November 20th, 2020. So that's why it's good to go through these things every 6 months. September and March for me is a natural time in the calendar to look at these things. So you can see in day two for her, she would have ham salad, chicken salad, and I found this at Whole Foods. It's a tuna substitute, so fish-free tuna. My son is plant-based or vegan, so for those of you, there are options specifically in Whole Foods. You can get these sometimes also at Costco, so chana masala. Then he prefers almond butter versus peanut butter, so I got him a couple almond butters. one peanut butter. Then there's vegan jerky. There's also vegan jerky on Amazon that we've ordered from before. And you know, make sure to get a variety of flavors, because when you're out, there's an emergency, there's stress, food can be a comfort for you. So get things that you will enjoy and get as much variety as you can. So this is a maple bacon, smoky Carolina barbecue. Wow, that sounds great. Perfect pepperoni, nice. And this is fish free tuna. And this is also fish free tuna, and the flavor is Mediterranean. So you wanna get a variety. I hope you enjoyed this video. Let me know in the comments below an essential that you would put in your 72-hour emergency food kit, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye. Is the clutter in your home leaving you exhausted? I can help you stop living in chaos. Go to my website and schedule a free 20-minute virtual home organizing assessment, simplysherry.com. Click the pink button, Get Organized Today. It'll bring you to a page for Calendly. Choose the time that works for you, and you will receive an email with a Zoom call link. I look forward to helping you. All this time you thought would never pay the price.